You're gone and I gotta stay.
Four Babas and their connections to netas and jails. On number 4, we have Swami Nithyananda. On January 2016, posters came up in Indore announcing the Simhast Fair in Ujjain to be held later that year. These posters were paid for by the government. Some of these posters had the photo of rape-accused Swami Nithyananda in them. In 2010, he was even welcomed in Gujarat by the Chief Minister Narendra Modi. Even after his allegations became common knowledge and after he had spent 50 days in jail, he was still welcomed grandly by Congress Pondicherry Minister P. Rajavelu in 2014. On number 3rd, we have Asaram Bapu. Another rape-accused Baba, he was on good terms with both Congress and BJP leaders. Digvijay Singh even sat at the feet of this man, while Narendra Modi, as the Chief Minister, was happy to welcome him. He has been in jail since 2013, but the court trial is still pending against him. In fact, 6 witnesses have been attacked and 2 killed while he was behind bars. On number 2nd, we have Chandra Swami. Just because a godman is well connected to political leaders doesn't mean that they are righteous. India realized this first through Chandra Swami. He rose to the heights of fame, meeting Margaret Thatcher, the Sultan of Brunei, even Saddam Hussein. Back home, he was said to be close to Prime Ministers Narasimha Rao and Indira Gandhi. In 1996, he was arrested on a case of financial fraud, similar to many other cases which would emerge against him. More seriously, he was accused in the assassination of Rajiv Gandhi. As allegations and rumors arose, scandal became the middle name of Chandra Swami. He quietly disappeared from the spotlight and died earlier this year. On 1st, Gurmeet Ram Rahim. The man of the hour, Ram Rahim has been asked to bless election candidates from every party. In 2007 Punjab election, the Dera announced its support for the Congress, while in 2017 it supported the Akali Dal and BJP. In fact, the Akali Dal went to seek these blessings even in 2007. The fact is that BJP went soft on the Dera followers. How do you explain lakhs of people being allowed to gather even after them warning of violence? This goes the other way too. The Haryana Education Minister described the Dera followers as peace-loving people on Thursday, a day before the violence scene.